Now we are discussing the line discipline. So talking about the line discipline, it is the one of the function of second layer, that means the data link layer of OSI model. Well, you can see that this one is the OSI model where we are having the seven layers, and inside that we are having the second layer, which is data link layer. And in the data link layer, the first functionality we are having is the line discipline. These all functionalities combinedly called the data link control. If we talk about the line discipline, then it gives the answer of the question that who should send now. It is also shown in the diagram that data link control, that means all the data link protocols combinedly are called data link control. There we are having the line discipline. And in this line discipline, we are having first thing that should be who should send now. That means if the multiple systems are connected through one line or one channel. Now, in that channel or line, there should be some kind of discipline. Discipline means if all people are sending at the same time, or maybe two are sending, then there will be the chance of collision. But if all are disciplined that they know when to send, if I say that on first minute I will send, on second minute you will send, then there will be no chance of collision. So who should send first? That should be taken care by the line discipline. So we can say that in the line discipline, it determines which device can send and what can send. It is not saying that who will start. It will also inform that what to say. That means if you are starting, then what you want to send. Then both things are decided by this line discipline. And one more thing, it provides the coordination of transmission, and also it coordinates with the link system. That means what is the transmission going on, that it is coordinating, and also it is coordinating with the link system that who should send now. So these two things are coordinated with the help of line discipline. So now we are discussing that how to achieve this line discipline. So we are now learning that line discipline can be done in two ways. So now talking about the line discipline, they can be done in two ways. Means there are two ways by which we can achieve this line discipline. So the first one which we are having is called the ENQACK. That is called inquiry acknowledgement. So talking about the line discipline as per the diagram, you can see that the first one is the ENQACK. That means inquiry and acknowledgement. We are giving an inquiry, then in the reverse we are getting the acknowledgement. It is used in the peer-to-peer system. Now there they are saying the peer-to-peer communication. Obviously, whenever we are having only one system, and that system I am assuming that this is C1, and there is another system we are having, and that is called the C2. Now whenever there is a two systems which are connected, there is nobody else in between, that is called the peer-to-peer communication. So here the inquiry and acknowledgement system work. Now there is a second type by which we can achieve the line discipline. So that is called poll and select. As you can see in the diagram, there is a second type which is poll and select. Now whenever there is a system which is primary and there are other systems which are secondary, then that is where the poll and select is used. So we can say that it is used in primary and secondary communication. Now talking about the primary and secondary, if I take the example in a class, whenever the faculty is there, we are assuming that that is primary, then students are there, that is called secondary. If primary says that now this student has to talk, the student will give the answer. So this is how the primary is given the information and secondary work on that. Means all the secondary take the simple thing from the primary. So this is called the primary and secondary. Let us suppose that I take some example. Let us suppose that there we are having is a server, and that server is connected with different system. Let us suppose that we are having the system which is C1. We are having another system which is, let us suppose, C2. Now these systems are connected with the server. So these are connected via one line. This is a multi-point communication, means one is communicating with all and this one is a server. So server here is the primary and the systems are the secondary. Now systems will follow the server. So this is how we are working with the poll and select. So these are the two methods or the ways by which we can achieve the line discipline.